Are you able to see the picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Classical partitioning. Okay, so this is one of the most popular experiment that is carried out by Ivan Pavlov. Okay. Now, I hope after explaining this experiment, you people will be able to understand what is this unconditioned stimulus, conditioned stimulus, and all those things. So here you can see a bell is here, a bell. Okay, this is a bell, and there is a dog here. Okay, so here the bell. A bell is a neutral stimulus. Neutral stimulus means, wait. Okay, so neutral stimulus means any stimulus that is not having the ability to elicit any response. Okay, neutral stimulus won't be able to elicit any response. So here the neutral stimulus is bell. Okay, a dog is here, a bell is here. The bell is neutral stimulus. Now the unconditioned stimulus here is food. Okay, food or meat or whatever. So this is unconditioned stimulus. Okay, so when unconditioned stimulus, that is the food or meat, is given to the dog, the dog started salivating. Is it clear? When you give meat or food to the dog will start salivating. That salivating is the unconditioned response. Are you able to follow me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
So we have given the dog a plate of meat or food or whatever. So that is the unconditioned stimulus here. Okay. So when we give the food to the dog started salivating, and the salivating is what? The unconditioned response. So this is what happened before conditioning process. Okay, before conditioning. Now the next step or next phase of this experiment is, we have paired the food and the bell. I hope if you people are having any pets in your home, or this conditioning is something that we all use in our day-to-day life. Okay, yeah. Even the advertising companies and all things, they are, this classical conditioning is like an application. We used to say that, I have conditioned to this. Actually, that term is coming from this experiment. Okay. So during conditioning, what happened is we have paired the food and bell. Okay. So first we'll be ringing the bell. Okay. After that, we'll be giving the food to the dog. Okay. There won't be much time gap between the presentation of bell and food. Okay, so what do you think will happen after a point of time, like after conditioning? What do you think? Any idea? First there was bell. Okay, there was no food, and even after, if you ring the bell, the dog won't be responding or not doing anything. Then what you did is you have given a plate of food to the dog. So by getting the food, the dog started salivating. This is what happened before conditioning. During conditioning, what happened is you have paired the food and bell. So what will happen? First you will ring the bell and you will give the food. Okay, first you will ring the bell and you will give the food. So by after a point of time, what happened is, after conditioning, is there any food here? Can you see any food here? Yeah, I'm asking you, is there any food here in after conditioning?
No.
But what happened is, the dog was conditioned here. Okay, so the dog started salivating just by hearing the sound of bell, because the dog is thinking, okay, once the bell Okay, just take the example of any soap, okay, Lex or something. And I think Aishwarya Rai or somebody, like some celebrities, and that, okay? So, you know, we are repeatedly exposed to this pairing, this soap and this celebrity, okay? If this Lex soap is presented to you without any celebrity, the Lex is a neutral stimulus. Okay, we don't have any response for that. But once the Lex soap is paired with the celebrity, like for a lot of time repeatedly, we are exposed to that. We have, you know, developed a kind of condition towards this. So what will happen if you go to a market, okay, if you go to a market or a shop to buy a soap, you'll automatically go to this Lex, because consciously or unconsciously, it is conditioned inside you that Aishwarya Rai is somehow, you know, conditioned with this Lex soap. So you will be developing a tendency to buy this product. This is something that is very common in all the products. You know, Boost is the secret of my energy, and you know, Dhoni and other cricketers, they used to do that. So there is a pairing is happening. We are conditioned to that. Even in our own lives, okay? We used to condition so many habits with so many results. Say, for example, a birthday is associated or paired with a birthday cake, okay? So like that, there are so many examples, any number of examples you can take from your life, okay? So here, what is the unconditioned stimulus? Can you tell me? What is the unconditioned stimulus? Yeah, what is the unconditioned stimulus?
Food,
okay? The food was unconditioned stimulus, okay? And it then paired with the bell. Bell was a neutral stimulus. When this neutral stimulus associated with this unconditioned stimulus, it become a conditioned stimulus. So unconditioned stimulus plus conditioned stimulus give response to unconditioned response in the beginning, and this unconditioned response, that is salivating, okay, it become a conditioned stimulus. That is, even if you are not giving food, it become conditioned. So here the neutral stimulus, the bell, that become the conditioned stimulus, and the salivation, okay, that was like an unconditioned response, that become a conditioned response to this conditioned stimulus. So now, are you clear with the terms? What is conditioned stimulus, what is conditioned response, what is unconditioned stimulus or unconditioned response? Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, you have to go and search about some examples and write it down. Then only you will be thorough with the concepts. Okay, otherwise there will be, you know, chances of getting confused. Okay? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so one more topic was, what are some of the basic principles of classical conditioning? There are basically four principles, okay? Acquisition, extinction,